I really like the looks of this big old tree. I love the way the branch dips down towards the water and all the branches are visible. That's a good thing about winter trees. You can really see the structure. I'm going to try something a little different on this sketch. I've mixed up some sepia and some burnt sienna, and I'm going to use that to actually create my sketch. This will be quicker, a little wilder, a little freer. And if I make a mistake, it won't matter too much because tree branches can bend any direction. I do want to keep it rather pale in case I do change my mind. That'll be the basic trunk shape. Using the half inch flat brush, it's just about the right width for some of these bigger branches. Don't be afraid to be creative as you're sketching the tree. You don't have to copy every branch that you see. You can reshape the tree at will. That's part of your artistic license. So if you see something you'd like to change or there's just too many branches in an area, you're the artist. Feel free to change it. I'm also establishing some of the tonal variations, putting the shadows in just a little bit darker to help me remember as I'm painting to get darker in those areas. This is applied wet on wet, so it's flowing just a little bit. That'll be nice for an under effect. I've got the basic structure completed. I don't have to do a lot of the detail or all the little twigs. Those can be added later. I do want to indicate the back of the pond, and the pond would be put in very straight because if it was slanted, of course, the water would fall out. I'm going to use a ruler just for a straight edge to guide my eye. Bring that up and make sure that my pond lays in there straight. Okay, just above the water line. In the photo, the curve actually touches the edge of the bank. I want to put it just a touch higher so that they don't touch. They call it the kiss of death, where things barely touch. Looks really awkward in a painting. So you want two things to meet either a little higher or a little lower than each other, rather than just barely touching. Okay, I think this will work. As a guide, that'll give me a nice, smooth, straight edge for my bank. If I want to tuck it back a little bit, the bank goes up, and then I can make a recess. But that wouldn't be curved downward. Because of the point of view, you wouldn't be seeing it as you would an airplane. It wouldn't look curved. It just looks like it's set back just a little bit. So that'll work nicely. Branches hanging a little lower. That'll help that area quite a bit. Okay, now I'm ready to put in some color and start my sky. I'm going to put that in very faintly so that I can draw twigs, branches, and fill in over the top of it. So it's going to be a winter blue, a pale ultramarine blue. I'm going to put just a touch of Payne's Gray in that mixture, bring out the winter colors. And I'm going to wet my background so it flows nicely. I'm going around the branches, but you don't have to be really careful because the branches are quite a bit darker than the sky, and I can paint right over it if need be. I've taped the edges. This will keep my paper from actually buckling when I use these heavy wet-on-wet techniques. Okay, now for the Kleenex. Wet it up like I did on the edge of the background for the bird, and just bring it in and create some really fun light cloud effects. I can also use the brush to remove any paint that I want to lighten an area just a little bit. I want a little interest in the sky, but it's going to be so overwhelmed by the tree in front of it that I don't want it too busy. In this case, simplified would be better. This is still quite damp in this area, and I want to add the background before it gets completely dry, so I'm going to re-dampen right at the horizon line. And while I'm doing this, I'm thinking of color mixtures. I see greens, kind of a wintry green with lots of brown in it. So I'm going to mix up a few of these colors in my palette. A little bit of sienna back there and some ochre. More shadow at the bottom of the trees, and I'm bringing up into a lighter green at the top. Where that's dry just a little bit, I'm adding a touch of water so that it can flow naturally up into the sky area. I'm going to blot my brush and just flick. That'll give me some staggered treetop effects. This would be a good time to also use that bruising technique. Well, the background trees are dry, so I can continue on down and get the ground right behind the pond. I'm going to use pretty much the same colored mixtures to keep a continuity, but I think I'll brighten it just a little bit. I'll show you what I mean here. I'm going to dampen it first. Blot it. And I'm ready to begin. This is short grass. There's a little bit of dirt and a little bit of underbrush in there, so I can bring those colors in also. I'm going to lay this first. Coming forward and down the bank, I'm going to pick up the ochres, the siennas, brush that down in. It's going to blend naturally with the wetter paint above it and give me the bank effect, like it's turning down into the water. With the number 4 round detail brush, I can pick up some of the darker colors. Dark areas caused by a bit of shadow, but also by the wet water making a little mud on the edge. It's a lot more interesting if you vary your strokes and vary the edge of the bank so that it doesn't look continuous. So I'm going a little high here and there, dipping down, narrow edge, and so on and so forth. The next step is to work on that water. Just a little bit of color, a little bit of reflection. So again, I'll wet that area. Blot off the extra. Pull the color down from the bank above, like so. It should be a little paler than the color it's reflecting from. This is a very subtle way to make a reflection, but very easy to control and to lay down. Reflections are a reverse of what you see, of course, just like when you look in a mirror. And so I'm going to get a little bit of the brown bank, about that far down, and then I'll pick up the green, and after that the green trees. This will be a little more distant, so I won't have quite as bright a green when I put that on. Just a suggestion as it pulls down through here. It may dry just a little lighter than you want it, so I'm going to let this dry and take another look at it. I've been considering the water as I watch it dry. I like what's happened, but I think I want to add a little bit right here in the corner. The branch comes down, swoops down and off, but it kind of leaves me hanging. It'd be really nice to carry me on down into the foreground and back up the tree. I think I have just the thing. Earlier I was sketching some of the birds that I've seen in the area, and I caught a gray heron standing in the water. That would be perfect. I'm going to sketch it in and see how it looks. Now for the foreground. I filled my rapidographs with sepia ink this time. It'll be a little more subtle, but it'll be really dark. I'm using a 0.25, 0.35, and just for fun, I've got a sepia marker. Well, the tree's done. It's got plenty of texture, lots of branches. I think I better stop before we overdo. I've looked at the composition. I'm pleased with most of it, but the bird does need to be darkened just a little bit because the branch comes down. He's so pale, you'll hardly notice him. I want him to help continue to bring your eye down and around. So I'm going to darken his feathers just a touch. And just a bit of brown on that beak. And a touch of orange on those legs, sienna and orange mix. And I think we're pretty close to finished. It's really fun to see it come together. The ideas that are formed by the photograph and what you see in your mind is really fun to bring it together, create, add some artistic license. Last thing, sign your name and say, I did this. I think that's what it's all about, bringing nature into your home the way that you individually see it. I've really had a lot of fun sketching today and showing you what you can do with nature. It's my favorite subject, and I hope with a lot of practice, it will be yours too. It's really a lot of fun to enjoy nature and learn at the same time.